Guys, this is Prabhakar Kumar and this is my first video on YouTube. Today I'm gonna show how to design a website using Adobe Muse. Adobe Muse is an Adobe Creative Suite software and it is used to design HTML websites. So let's start. I have downloaded my trial version of Adobe Muse here, and this is the interface which you will see after installing Adobe Muse. Okay, and before this we would have to download Adobe Muse from the Adobe website and install Adobe Creative Cloud here. Okay, and this is a lengthy process. It takes around 15 minutes to 1.5 hours depending on the internet speed you have and the system speed, like the RAM, the memory, everything of your computer. It takes a lot of time, so I didn't want to take a lot of time of yours. And this software will help you in designing HTML websites with no coding. You don't have to get into programming HTML, CSS, HTML5, PHP, WordPress, anything. You just have to download this software, Adobe Muse, and get started. Alright, so here we go. We can click on File and then a new site. This is the interface. This is a new site. The classic Adobe interface. Before creating a new file, let it be in Photoshop, let it be in Illustrator, let it be anywhere. So I'm creating a website for desktop. It has got an option for tablet and mobile phone too. That's Adobe add-on these days. And let's say I've got a website page width of say 1024, sorry for that, and my minimum height would be, let's say, 1250. Let's reduce the website width to, as it is, 960. Okay, the footage should be sticky, everything is okay, center horizontally. Alright, now this is the second page we get, and it gives us an option to create pages here: home, about us, services, contact us, anything. Okay, and this is the master page here. Alright, so what a master page is: a master page to an HTML website is something like the most important page. All the pages of the HTML website would have the same design, the same skeleton of it. Okay, so we have to design the master page first. We want the website to be of a same skeleton, not of different haywire design. Okay, so we have to design the master page first. But before designing the master page, we got to go to the website tab, and this website designing software works in tabular design, like website 1, A Master, home. Okay, so let's say that I would have 3 pages to my website: about us and contact us. So this is a mini HTML website I'm gonna design as a test, not for anyone. So let's go to the master page here. Okay, let's have a look at this. This is our master page. It's not going to be at any page end. It's not going to be displayed on the website while the user visits your website. But this is, believe me, the most important page of your website. Alright, so take a better care of this page. Now, before designing this page, let's see how it looks on a web browser before it is designed. Like this, it's a default way of Adobe putting through a web page here. So let's see how it looks on a web browser. So we go to File and then we go to Preview Page in Browser. We click, it's checking preview connections here. It depends on your firewall and antivirus. And this is how your website would look like, your web page would look like after getting designed. And if you go ahead and see the page code, the page source, this is ready-made HTML web page. So you did not write these codes, okay? So Adobe did that for you. Adobe Muse specifically did that for you, all right? So you do not have to do anything before you design a website, not even go to those boring HTML classes on any other websites or any tutorials on the internet. Just download the software and get going to design a beautiful website. And you can also make it your business. You can also go commercial by designing HTML websites. You can get projects on the Lands, freelancer.com or odeskguru.com. And we got a new website, fiverr.com. It's F-I-V-E-R-R.com. It's a pretty cool website. So this is our master page, and I don't want to create a center page website. I would like to create a full width website, okay? So this is the browser fill, and if I have to create a full width website with white page all over, I have to delete this portion, the grayish portion here at the back. You can see that I have to delete that portion. So what I will do is I'll go here at the top. It says browser fill. I'll select it and I'll go to the white thing. I'll select the white color here and it goes all white. But you see here that there is a black outline of the main page still there. So this is not an outline. This is actually the stroke of an object. Stroke of an object in mainly in Adobe software. So you will see here that if you add an object, let it be an image, let it be an HTML object, let it be any object, it comes with a stroke like an outline, okay? So we have to cancel the stroke, we have to delete the stroke. So I go here and select none, it goes off, okay? So this is my master page now, and this is how my website will look like when it is previewed in the browser. So there is no gray background, no outline. My web page has got a length. You can see I can drag and drop here. I can drag here the page. Sorry, drag and drop. No, it's a drag here the page. So it has got length, it has got width. Okay. Now I'll close it. And now the most important thing of Adobe Muse software is the right side panel here. It has got hell lot of options. I'll tell you, you'll gotta know when you use the software, okay? So this is the page. I've minimized this option here. There is a button to get it minimized, so I did it. I've minimized it so I can get a better feel of the website being designed, okay? Now it comes to the header, the footer, and the content part, okay? It is very important to note that if you mess up with this part, you can make your website go wrong anyways, okay? So let's get it straightened out. You can see two lines here and three lines here at the bottom. So what are these lines? These lines are the selectors. You can select your header part and your footer part with these lines. So they are very, very important, okay? You would not get the, you would not get these lines in any of the pages you design. Let it be home, about us, contact us. This is only in the master page you get here, okay? So I'll select my header to start from the top, and then it goes till a bit. It can take down my logo here, then my phone number here, and anything I can write here. And then my menu comes down here, and then I come to the content part. This is the content part, and this is the footer. I have to select the footer very, very carefully. Okay, now I come down here. I come to see that this is bottom of the browser, okay? So when it comes to bottom of the browser, it is exactly the bottom when you drag the page down. It goes to the bottom. This is the bottom of the browser. Now I will mix it with bottom of the page, okay? I'll mix this with bottom of the page. So now they're overlaid, okay? This is footer. This is the selector where the footer starts from. So I will start my footer from here. So technically, if I see my website now, It has a footer section and a header section and a content area here. Okay, so this is my footer section, this is my header section, and this is my content portion. I can put anything I feel like, anything I feel like. Now comes the use of this right portion here. I have created three pages in my website: home, about us, and contact us. As I told you, that master page is not counted as a landing page on a website, so it'll not be displayed to any of your viewers. You can make changes to the a master page. Okay, so now we go to the master page and we start designing it. First of all, we will design a beautiful logo here. Okay, so I've got another software for you which you can use to design a logo. It is called the SoThink Logo Maker Professional. Please buy it, don't download the torrent files or hack it or use keygens. Please buy the software so that you can stay protected on your computer. And this is the software which gives you n number of options, n number of templates to design your logo here. Okay, so I'll pick any of the logo. Let's say I pick here. I click here, pick here Cloud Clinic. This looks beautiful. Cloud Clinic. Okay, now it's in the center. You can use it very easily. It's a pretty cool software. You can make it go at the top left so that you can give it a full size. Okay, do it here. I did not make any change with the logo. All right, so I go here, export image. Okay, let's make it 99, then export it, desktop, then test logo. I'll make a new folder here, test, open the folder and then place the logo there. Alright, I'll close it. I'll close this. No, it's already saved. Okay, I go to Adobe Muse. And then I have to place my logo, the website logo here. This is something which I can make and from anywhere. Let it be Illustrator, let it be SoThink Logo Maker, let it be any third-party software, anything. I go to File and then Place. Okay, Place is the command here which is used to place objects on this website or the web page. You can also use Control D. Control D would give you an option to place any object on the website. I go to desktop, I go to test, and then I place the logo. So this is how I can get the logo to the website done. I can click anywhere, release the logo, and it comes here. Now I would place the logo here. Okay, so this is the logo which I would place on the website, and I put a text here, like my toll-free number on the website. I put a text here. Okay, go to select and then I go to text. I put in the toll fee number, call +1-800-000-000. Okay, I select that and then I increase the font of this. Let's make it 36. Don't like the Arial font. I like either Tribution or Madonna. Okay. Come here. Okay. Alright. Now I have designed the header of my website. It does not look that much appealing. I mean, yes, using a software, you can rely on this and you can design a website with this. You can use your own imagination. This is only a test tutorial for Adobe Muse that I'm helping you with. So, all right, now to make my website more good, I can give some effects on this logo here. Come here, it goes to effects, and when I click on effects, I have shadow here. I put shadow color. I can can choose color. It goes grayish and opacity. Check the opacity. You can go here to 30. I go to 30 and angle 45. You can change the angle. It gives you a distance. Distance. You can increase the distance, decrease the distance. You can see at the background the changes being done in real time here. So you can increase the distance, decrease the distance. It's done now. Alright, now let's see. Let's put a professional header bar at the top. It would be a rectangle here. We need to select a rectangle, select it, and then make a rectangle here. Select here, and then make it thin, thin, thin. Thinner, as much thinner you can, and increase the length of this, and you could get it done like this. Select it, bring it to the top, and now, as I said, this would have a stroke, and it would not look good as a stroke object, so you can nullify the stroke as none. And then fill this rectangle with any color you feel like. My logo and my website feel is blue and green, so I go to blue and make it light blue here, and that's done. Okay, now I have my website done, I have my header done. I don't have the website done now, I have the header done, and it is Cloud Clinic, and this is my header. Now comes the turn for the menu. I go here on the right side panel and select menu here. I go to horizontal. It gives me two options, to put horizontal menu and vertical menu. So I take horizontal menu, I select it here and drag it here. This is the way to get the menu done. Okay. Now it gives me options here. Menus, which pages you want to have in the menus. Let's say that if you have sub pages on this website, home, home 1, home 2, home 3, home 4, about us 1, about us 2, about us 3, about us 4, contact us, feedback, inquiry, anything. So you can choose either top level pages or all pages or manually any pages. Alright, so direction is horizontal, edit together. When you select this checkbox, edit together, and you make any change here, and to fonts, the colors, or the size of the box, all the boxes, all the three boxes will be changed together. 1, 2, 3. If you want to put colors on this box, different colors in different boxes, you need to uncheck this. Edit together. You can put any three colors on these three boxes. So I'll go with edit together. It'll take less time and it'll give me less headache. Item size would be uniform. Show left icon, show label, yes. Show right icon, sub menus only. Right icon is a small down towards arrow here, which is shown when you check this, when you have this enabled, and you have a sub page here. When you have a sub page, the website will show you that yes, I do have menus here. Go down, click on there. So you can keep it enabled or disable it according to your choice. Parts positioning, horizontal, central. So you can put this menu in the center, and that is all for this. You have your menu selected. I will put my menu starting from here to here. Okay, this is the menu of the website. Home, about us, contact us. As I said that I don't like the Arial font, so this is not Arial as such, but this is not good. I will select the font and I'll go to fonts, it's Georgia actually. So I'll go to Tribution. When I do Tribution for home, you see here that it gets changed for about us and contact us too. So that helped us. Like this option, when I go and select this option, it says that it together. This option helped me to change about us and contact us together. Now my website feel is green and blue, and this content box is gray, so it does not look good in my website here. However, gray color looks good with anything. Okay. So I will first of all, I will not delete the stroke, but because its stroke is not visible, I can delete it if I feel like. You can delete it if you feel like. My fill, the color is gray here. I will go ahead and change the color to either blue or green. I choose blue. Green is not much of my favorite. I'll see blue. Okay, it goes here. All right, it it's done. Home, about us, contact us. This is my header. All done. Okay. Now I come here. I come down to my footer. Okay. So this footer needs to be much attractive, because I personally think that a website, the feel of a website looks much better if it has an attractive footer, because people, when they see the website, everything feels normal, but the footer, if the footer is classy, if the footer is cool, everybody feels like, yes, this is hell of a website. Okay, so what I did is I dragged a rectangle box here, and then I am making the rectangle box the size of my footer section, which would give me options to put something in the rectangle box. Okay, now it is done. Now, as I said, there must be a stroke here, so let's see the stroke. Oh yes, there comes the stroke, the black one. I would nullify the stroke as I usually do. Okay, my footer has a footer section, and that footer section, it has a rectangle. Okay, so it is done. Now, what I will do is I will put some color in this box here. Let's say gray. So footer, the color of the footer does not it is not necessary that you go and put matching colors to the header or the website color tone. You generally make it black, blue, green, orange, any color you feel like. So I'll make it black. I'll make the footer black. Okay, so I select the color black. All right, now it is done. Okay, so this is the website, and this is the footer of the website. You can put anything on the footer, either a menu or a PNG image or live chat here, anything. Okay, so this is the footer. Alright, so this is the header, and this is the footer, this is the content area. Now what I will do is I will save this website, because it is not saved yet. Okay, so I go to desktop, I go to test, the folder I created here, test, and then I go to website 1 or test website. Okay, oops. Okay, save. Now it is saving the website as test. Now what I will do is I'll check the preview of this website in the browser. Okay, so let's go Control Shift E, or the file page preview in browser. So this is how my website will look like, and it's a pretty brilliant feel on the next. How much time I have taken here, I don't know exactly, but it think it might have, I may have taken not more than 15 minutes or less. So this is a website which you can design in 15 minutes here using the software. Okay, this is only a header and a footer. The content area is missing, but you can do that. Okay, when you see the source of this, you can see a hell lot of coding here. You did not do that, neither I did. Look at that. Muse utils. Okay, so Adobe Muse did that for you. It's pretty awesome, cool software. Okay, alright, so close this preview. No need to be happy. We have to go with 3 more pages. Now, most of the websites come with slider. Yeah, slider are much into fashion these days. Okay, so you go to the right side panel and go to slideshows, and there are basic slideshows, blank slideshows, full screen, light box, thumbnails. There are many options you can choose from here, so I choose blank. I choose blank slideshows. I drag it here. Okay, and I minimize it. First of all, what I will do is I'll select the slider, put it to the size, what the size of my website is. Okay, and I'll make it done in no time. Alright, it's done. You can put it much. Okay, so this is one by one, and this is Laurel. You can give description to all the pages you put. So when you click here, it goes to the second page. We have one page selected here, so you can drag it here. Okay, you can drag it here, and it is images here. Okay, you can put, you can select images from here, all images. You can select any image from, let's see if I have some images here. I do not have any banner right now, but you can put any banner of this size here. Let's see the size. Okay, if I select that, it makes me feel that it's 920 by 369. So let's make it much shorter in height. 920 by 322. 325 is better. Okay, so this is the slider you can put here. Okay. Now let's see the preview, Control-Shift-E. This is the preview, this is how your slider would look like. And you can put images here. I showed how to put the images. Okay. Now our header section is complete. Okay, so you can leave space here for any advertisement you get from Google AdSense or AdCache. Alright, now let's go to, don't forget to click on Control Save, Control S. Okay, now close this A Master. We don't need that anymore. Now go to our home page. Okay, this is our home page. You'll see that this home page is completely like the A Master page. Alright, so I'll not design the home page completely for you here, but I will show you how to design that. You can put any image here, okay? So I'll put an image, Control D, I'll put your logo here, okay? So this is a logo, and you can put text, select this, and you can put text here. You can put, you can make any, you can make sections and put text. So this is home. And you select this. This is home. You do this. You can write anything here. All right. And the best thing with Muse you can do is you can select this and justify it to be in the center, and it will be in the center here. Okay, so I did this. This is my home page. This is my image. This is my footer. This is my slider. This is my header. Okay, so I did that. And now I'll save it. Okay, and now I close the home page and I go to About Us. Okay, then I see what exactly we do here. We go to About Us and I put the same image here. Okay, Control D, Cloud Clinic. And then put Cloud Clinic here. And I do not need to remind you that this is About Us. I already told you how to put text in it. Just click here, text, and then drag the box, make it bigger, make it sections, and then put text, write text, or copy text, anything if you like. Control S, it'll save it, and then close it. Contact us, contact us. Control D, Cloud Clinic. I put Cloud Clinic here, okay. And then this is the Contact Us page. You can put a contact form, or you can put anything you feel like here. And this would be your Contact Us page, or any page. Control S, it'll save it. Now, I'll show you what a favicon is, okay? So let's go to Something Logo Maker again. And this is a favicon. We took this Cloud Clinic, so I'll make a favicon. Favicon is actually the image which is in the head of the browser when you visit the website. So that gives you a feel that yes, this is a legit website. Sometimes it will give you a better feel than that. So favicon is one important part of a website, so you make it really carefully. Okay, you go to Adobe Muse and don't just export the website. Okay, so this is a favicon. I'll make a favicon here. Alright, export image. Just make sure that the height and width of the image is not more than 20, because it'll be a much bigger favicon to be. So we export this in PNG format, and I name it as FAV. Okay, save, close. Now I go to this website. Now my website is complete. Okay, my test website is complete. All right. Now what I will do is I'll preview this website in my browser. Okay, I go here and then I preview. I don't preview page in browser. I preview the complete site in browser. Preview site in browser. I do this. Okay, and this is my complete site. Okay, this is my home page. It gives me a home, 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 home. This is my cloud clinic. This is my footer. This is my slider. This is my header. About us, contact us. Now, if I go ahead and click on About Us, it'll take me to the About Us page. You see here, aboutus.html. Okay, and then it gives me a field that I am in the About Us page. Contact us. All the pages are pretty much the same, but yes, this is a test website for you. So this is my short, and it hardly took me 30 minutes to design a website, although a test website, but yes. So you can design your website in your according to your imagination and feel. So now what I will do is I'll export. Now you will have a question, how to upload this website to my domain, to my hosting. So Adobe has given you a feature to export this website into HTML. Okay, so I go to File, Export as HTML. Okay, and I'll give it a domain name, www.test.com, and I'll choose the folder. Where should it go? It goes to my Documents Muse export folder, but I don't want to be there. I don't want the website to be there. I want the website to be in the test folder. Okay, I make a folder. I make a new folder here to, let's say, HTML. Okay, and then I select this folder and like this. Okay, then I click OK, and the website is exported to my test folder. This is my website. About us, contact us. Now, okay, what of, oh, I forgot one thing. I'm sorry for that. I forgot to put in the favicon in the website. Okay, so my bad. Let's go to HTML. Open the HTML folder. You see CSS, images, scripts, about us, contact us, Muse manifest, sitemap. We did not get into these details, but Muse, Adobe Muse did all this for us. Okay, so thank you, Adobe Muse. You're really good software. Okay, go to Adobe Muse, and you need to put favicon on the website. So go to Site Properties, and you can see a favicon image here. Okay, you go to Desktop, and then go to Test, select the favicon. Okay, click on OK. That would be my favicon. Export as HTML. Okay. Alright, this is my HTML. Now you see here, this is the favicon I'm talking about. It gives your website a very good feel. When you're on a mobile site, this gives you a website a very good feel. And when you go to mobile site, when you open this website on a mobile, on a cell phone, you will see that this is not as much responsive as a WordPress or Drupal website, but yes, it is responsive. Okay. So if you come here, if you put it like this, okay, my screen size is much bigger than a normal screen size. It shows it to be. So when I come here and drag it to a smaller browser, it goes like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. Okay. So let's see here. This is my website, and let's close the Adobe Muse. Save. Yes, save it. Okay. And then I go to test. And I go to HTML, and this is my complete website. Okay. Okay, CSS, images, scripts, about us, contact us, index, muse manifest, sitemap. Okay, you did not build these files, but Adobe Muse did that for you, and you would be surprised to build a website in 30 minutes or so. Okay, you can make it a business, you can make it anything you feel like. Thank you very much for watching this video. You all have